Hello my dear students, welcome again for the online classes. Today we will start with the new lesson of history, tribes, nomads and settled communities. Now let us start with the video children. You saw in chapter number 2, 3 and 4 how the kingdoms rose and fell. Even as this was happening, new arts, crafts and production activities flourished in towns and villages. Over the centuries, important political, social and economic developments had taken place. But social change was not the same everywhere because different kinds of societies evolved differently. It is important to understand how and why this happened. Children, during the period of 8th to 18th century, important social, political and economic development had taken place. And the social changes were not the same everywhere. The changes, the social changes which took place were not the same everywhere, because different societies evolved differently. Now, since ancient times, the society in India was divided into varnas, which were according to the rules given by the Brahmanas. See here children, in the second paragraph also it is given. In the large part of the subcontinent, society was already divided according to the rulers of varna. These rules as prescribed by the Brahmanas were accepted by the rulers of large kingdom. The difference between the high and the low and between the rich and the poor increased day by day. Under the Delhi Sultans and the Mughals, this hierarchy between social classes grew further. Now the division by which the society was divided into high and low caste was accepted by all. And under the Delhi Sultan, this division of society into the varnas was further intensified by the formation of the jatis or subcaste. Now children, let us see how was the life in the tribal societies. That is, beyond the big cities, let us see how was the tribal societies. There were, however, other kind of societies as well. Many societies in the subcontinent did not follow the social rules and rituals and which were prescribed by the Brahmanas, nor were divided into the unequal classes. Such societies were called tribes. Members of each tribe were united by kinship bond. Many tribes obtained their livelihood from agriculture. Others were hunter-gatherers or herders, and most often they combined these activities to make full use of the natural resources of these of the area in which they lived, because there was no other option for them to earn their livelihood. And some tribes were nomadic and moved from one place to another. Now children, you have been studying about the nomadic life of the people. Early man used to live in the forest. He used to move from one place to another in search of food. Slowly from hunter gatherer he moved towards the hunter. He became the producer also, but that has taken place during the different stages. Now children, a tribal group controlled the land and the pasture jointly and divided this amongst the households according to its own rule. These tribes believed in the social equality of all members. Now the members of the society were divided by the kinship bond. Children, it is already mentioned here. And children, the land and the pastures were controlled directly, jointly, and produced was divided among the households according to their own rule. Means whatever production they had, it was divided among them. And the main source of, as it is given, the main source of the livelihood was hunting, agriculture, and herding. However, both the caste-based and the tribal societies were interdependent, and many large tribes thrived in the different parts of the subcontinent. They usually lived in the forest. These tribes, they lived in forests, hills, and deserts, and the places which were difficult to reach. Sometimes they clashed with the more powerful caste-based societies. In various ways, the tribes retained their freedom and preserved their separate culture. Both the caste-based and the tribal societies also depended on each other for their diverse needs. Now children, both, they were dependent on each other. This relationship of conflicts and dependence gradually caused by both the societies to change. And this way, children, the life in the tribal societies, people, this is about the life in the tribal societies. So children, I hope you have understood how the tribes and the nomads move from one place to another, and they had settled their communities. Children, as this is the introductory lecture, today I will just explain you about the settlement, and in the next lecture we will move towards how were the tribal people, then how did they spend their life, how the nomads and the mobile people lived, so what was the difference between them. So for today, just introductory part of the lesson is explained. I hope you have understood. Today you will read the lesson thoroughly and try to understand the concept. Thank you.